Hello friends, welcome to this session on triangles. In the previous video, we discussed the RHS congruence rule. Today, as we move forward, we will discuss one more property of triangles, which is the SSS congruence rule. Friends, the name itself suggests that this rule of congruence is related to the sides of triangles. Look at the given triangles. Are these triangles congruent? Friends, the rules of congruence that we learned so far, such as SAS, ASA, AAS and RHS, have at least one angle in them. But in these triangles, no information is given about the angles. Only the length of the sides are given. So how can we check the congruence of these triangles? Friends, let us take a paper and by using the given length of the sides, let's construct a triangle. Here, in triangle ABC, let's consider BC as the base and draw a line of length 5 cm. Now, take the measurement of AC in a compass, which is 4 cm. Place it on point C and draw an arc. Now, take a measurement of 3 cm in a compass, place it on point B and draw another arc. The intersection point of these two is point A. Similarly, we will draw triangle PQR. Now cut the triangles and keep similar sides one on top of the other. You can see that these two triangles cover each other completely. This means the corresponding parts of these triangles are equal. That's why triangle ABC and triangle PQR are congruent. Here, two pairs of triangles are given. You can pause the video and repeat the activity to test if these triangles are congruent. Observe the first pair. The three sides of the first triangle are equal to the three sides of the other triangle. That's why they are covering each other completely. Therefore, these triangles are congruent. In the second pair, two sides of the triangles are equal. But the third side is not equal. They don't completely cover each other. That's why these two triangles are not congruent. So, we can say that for two triangles to be congruent, two sides being equal is not enough. Here, for triangles to be congruent, all three sides should be equal. We can write this conclusion in the form of a theorem. If three sides of one triangle are equal to the three sides of another triangle, then the two triangles are congruent. This is called the side-side-side or SSS congruence rule. So, if three sides of two triangles are equal, then they are congruent according to the SSS congruence rule. And we know that the corresponding parts of congruent triangles are equal. So, the corresponding angles will also be equal. That's it for today's session. Today, we discussed the side-side-side criterion or SSS congruence rule. See you in the next video. Thank you.